Hi, I'm Jared Bentley. You're watching The Week in Review on JohnsonCityPress.com. Hurricane Matthew is letting his presence be felt along the East Coast today after hitting Haiti with a mighty storm and a heavy burden over the past few days. The death toll in Haiti is expected to be over 300, with thousands more losing homes and suffering injury. The storm is making landfall in the United States as I speak, and many southeastern communities have issued mandatory evacuation orders. We'll do our very best here at JohnsonCityPress.com to keep you up to date with the effects of the storm as it makes its way along the southeastern coast. We wish everyone a very safe outcome and hope for the best. The Tri-Cities region is back in the national news again this week as the mother of a Bluff City student has requested the removal of a textbook that includes information about Islam. At the end of Monday night's Sullivan County School Board meeting, board member Mark Ierson made a motion to remove the Pearson 7th grade social studies textbook immediately because it does not represent the values of the county. Ierson's plea came after an impassioned speech from Bluff City Middle School parent Michelle Edmiston, the sole public commenter. "I will not give up this fight," said Edmiston. "Right this wrong tonight." However, after Ierson's motion, school system officials said there is a textbook removal policy in place that is to be followed, including the parent filling out a form and the formation of a committee on the matter, and that the matter could be addressed at a future called board meeting. "My child's personal religious beliefs were violated," said Edmiston, adding that her 7th grade daughter took zeros on the section on Islamic history after a teacher didn't allow her to opt out of the curriculum and do alternative studies. "Those are zeros that we proudly took and we will not compromise." In remarks that drew applause, she called for removal of the book and to stand with the moral compass upon which she said the United States was founded, and to take back our families, schools, and our country. Moses Ballard, who was convicted on August 25th of second-degree murder in the shooting death of Michael Rowe, received his sentence this week. Ballard has been sentenced to 38 years in prison by Washington County Criminal Court Judge Stacy Street, citing his numerous opportunities to turn away from criminal behavior before the deadly night Michael Rowe was killed and his reluctancy to do so. Ballard, 31, is already serving a total of 20 years on two prior convictions. He was on probation at the time of Rowe's shooting death and has since been ordered to serve 8 years in an aggravated assault conviction, which started out as an attempted murder shooting case, and 12 years on a drug sale conviction. He will serve the 38 years on top of those prior sentences for a total of 58 years. He's eligible for parole after serving 30% of the 20 years and 35% of the 38 years. Lots of things going on this weekend throughout the region as the National Storytelling Festival is taking place in Jonesboro, the Apple Festival in Irwin, plenty of other entertainment options throughout the Tri-Cities, just a lot happening in this first week of October. So if you get the chance, we suggest you get out and enjoy yourself. This has been The Week in Review on JohnsonCityPress.com. Thank you very much for watching.